Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to create a model for this related rates problem. A 25-foot ladder is leaning against the wall of a house. The base of the ladder is pulled away from the wall at a rate of 2 feet per second. Find the rate at which the angle between the ladder and the wall of the house is changing when the base of the ladder is 7 feet, 15 feet, and 24 feet from the wall. Here are our handwritten or hand-calculated analytics for this problem. I've created a chart so that we can have all that information here so that we can easily refer back to it once we get our model working. Alright, let's label the pieces that we have. So here we have the right triangle where the hypotenuse is L for the ladder. Here is the ground for one leg. We're going to label that X. And the wall, the other leg, we're going to label that Y. And the angle that we're looking at is this angle here, theta. We're trying to figure out the rate at which this angle is changing as the bottom of the ladder is sliding either in or out. All right, what we know is that now we need to find an equation that we can relate to this particular problem. Well, we're going to use the sine function. We're going to use the sine of theta because sine gives us the opposite side over the hypotenuse. And here what that means that we have X over L. The other piece of information that I want to add on here is that we know the rate at which the bottom of the ladder is sliding out, and that's symbolized by dx dt, and we know that rate is 2. What we need to do now is we need to solve this equation for theta. Well, to do that, we need to take the arc sine of both sides of this equation. So here we're going to have the arc sine of sine theta, and that's going to equal the arc sine of X over L. Well, in doing so, the arc sine of sine theta is just theta, and then we're left with the arc sine of X over L. So now what we have to do is take this equation here and make this equation into a parametric equation so that we can model how the equation changes over time. So to do that, we're going to take the variable X, and we're going to set X equal to 2t. And the reason why we're using the constant 2 is because we see that our dx dt is a 2. So what that means is I can rewrite this equation with the expression 2t in place of the x. So here I can say theta is equal to the arc sine of 2t over L. So now I have my two parametric equations. So this here will be my first one, and this here will be my second one. Now, before we put this into the model, let's just look at the model currently. On the model, you'll notice we have three different sliders. A slider for the length of the ladder, a slider for dx dt, or the rate at which the bottom of the ladder is moving, and a slider for time. We're going to use that information to substitute back into these equations so that we can have a more dynamic model. So here, instead of writing the number 2, we're going to use dx dt because the slider controls what that value is going to be. We also said that t stands for time. So now our expression for the x variable is dx dt times time. And we're going to do the same thing for the equation with theta. So here we have theta is equal to the arc sine. And instead of 2t, we just showed that that can be rewritten as dx dt times time. And all that will be over L, in which we set L is the length of the ladder. All right, so these two expressions here are going to be the expressions that we enter into our parametric equation in the model. So let's go ahead and begin the creation or the addition of this functionality to our model. All right, we're going to begin by placing a point at the origin. So let's put in point 0, 0. And I want to change the color of that point. I want to change it to be black like the other points. Next thing I want to do is I need to create an angle here because I want to see what the current measure of the angle is. And then we'll get to the rate of change of the angle. So let's select angle. And see here for the angle, we need to select three points. So we're going to select the point C, that's why we added that point on there, point B, and then point A. And then notice that we now have, whoops, let me just grab this. Notice that we have the current measure of this angle. So here we see angle alpha is currently measuring 36 and 87 hundredths degrees. And if I move the time slider, we see that we can get an accurate account of what the angle measure is currently. Next, let's call up the curve function. So we're going to write curve. Oops, let's try that again. Curve. And I want the curve that allows two expressions. The first expression is going to be dx dt times time. And again, that's what we have here for x. And then for the second expression, we're going to use the arcsine. And we want the arcsine of, let's add a fraction, we want the arcsine of dx dt times time. Oops, let's go back. Actually, let me just retype that whole thing. So we have curve. We want two expressions. The first expression was dx dt times time. Second expression was the arcsine. In the numerator, we wanted dx dt times time. And for our denominator, we want to put in here ladder. The parameter value or parameter variable is going to be time. It's going to be associated with it with the time slider. The start value is going to be 0. And the end value is going to be ladder divided by dx dt. And that's going to tell us how long it takes the model to run based on the current length of the ladder. And really, whoops, and I misspelled that. That was a sine. All right, and if we scroll over, let me just slide this over. You'll see that we used ladder divided by dx dt on the other parametric equations as well. All right, so if you look at the model, you'll see that it drew in this current curve. We don't need to see the curve, so let's turn it off. And also, let's rename this. This here is going to be called top angle. All right, and if we look at the x value is going to tell us at what rate the bottom of the ladder is sliding. And the y variable here is going to tell us what the current value of theta is, and that's what we see right here. But what we want to do in this question, though, is we want to figure out the rate at which this angle is changing. And to do that, we need to just take the derivative. So there's a derivative function. Let's select curve, and we want to take the curve of top angle, and that's the parametric equation that we just labeled here. We press enter. And now we have the equations for the rates of change, where x is the rate of change of the bottom of the ladder and y is the rate of change of this angle. And notice we have a vertical line drawn in, and we can turn that off. We don't want to see that as well. Right now, let's create some text so that we can see what those values are. So let's come here and let's create something called, let's use the function called fraction text. All right, and the text that we want to grab the y value from top angle prime, because again, that represents the rate of change, and we want that at a specific moment in time, and that specific moment in time is going to be captured by whatever the value this time slider currently has. And then let's press enter there. And now let's go here and let's add some more information so that we can, so it looks better when we place it on the screen here. So we know this is going to be radians. And let's go back on it so we get this screen here. All right. Let's use the frac function, where the numerator is going to be radians. The denominator is going to be seconds. Let's add a label in the front of this. Again, we want it to be a fraction. And we want, in the numerator, we want to put d theta. And let's go down here to advanced. Let's grab the Greek letters. We want theta, which is here. So we want d theta dt, and we want an equal sign there. And then let's click OK. And now let's take this label and let's move this label here. Let's right click on it and let's go to absolute positioning on the screen. All right, so now as we move the slider around, we see that the radian measures are changing. Now let's go back to our table. And when x is 7, we expect the radian measure to be 1/12 radians per second. So let's go and make sure here this first number tells us how many feet from the wall is currently set at 5. Let's slide the timer over till that moves to 7. And when it's at 7, we see we are at 1/12 radians per second. Let's go over to exponent 15 and we should see 1/10 radians per second. So let's go over to 15. All right, once we're at 15, we do see 1/10 radians per second. And then lastly, let's go over when x is 24 and we should see 2/7 radians per second. So let's go all the way over to 24. And we do see 2/7 radians per second. And then lastly, like I've shown in previous tutorials, I can click on the button here to animate. I can change the speed of the animation. And we see that as this is going through the motions here, we see that all of our labels and information here is showing us what the current values are for the particular when we can figure out, when we see how far the bottom of the ladder is from the wall. All right, well, that sums it up for AJSpeller.com. Thank you for viewing this video and have a great evening.